Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Monday, SpaceX successfully launched their 118th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 12-1.
One, ignition, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Falcon.
The booster which launched this mission, B1080, then landed successfully for the 13th time on the drone ship. Just read the instructions.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy. Stage 1 landing confirmed.
Earlier this morning, SpaceX successfully launched their 119th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 676.
1. Ignition. And liftoff. Go Falcon. Go Starlink.
The booster which launched this mission, B1078, then landed successfully for the 15th time on the drone ship, a shortfall of gravitas.
The guidance.
Stage 1 landing leg deploy.
We can hopefully still expect to see a couple of Falcon missions launched this week. The next launch, the Starlink 665 mission, is currently scheduled for Saturday 30th at 5 a.m. UTC or 12 a.m. EST. Then a few hours later and we should see a customer mission launch. The NROL 126 mission is currently scheduled for Saturday 30th at 8:08 a.m. UTC or 3:08 a.m. EST. Related to the second Starlink landing we saw, SpaceX posted some information. They said Falcon 9 has landed, completing our 375th overall recovery of an orbital class booster. There was an article posted by NASA about SpaceX being selected to launch a super exciting mission. It says NASA has selected SpaceX to provide launch services for the Dragonfly mission, a rotorcraft lander mission under NASA's New Frontiers program designed to explore Saturn's moon Titan. The Dragonfly mission currently has a targeted launch period from July 5, 2028 to July 25, 2028 on a SpaceX Falcon Heavy rocket from Launch Complex 39A at NASA's Kennedy Space Center in Florida. Chris Burgin posted some information about a new gigabay that SpaceX is hiring for. It says SpaceX has opened a job listing for the next vertical integration facility for Starship construction at Starbase, Texas. This could be a possible gigabay, as SpaceX called it in the listing before editing out that word to replace the high bay or possibly all of SpaceX's vertical integration facilities currently in Starbase, including Megabay 1 and 2. Alex from NSF posted some information about when we could expect to see Starship Flight 7. It says it looks like Starship 7 flight is currently no earlier than January 11th based on recent documentation that NASA filed with the FAA. It appears that the agency's Gulfstream 5 plane will be used to observe the re-entry of Ship 33, which will be over the Indian Ocean. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.